Matt, can you hear me? Just type in move topic or something. Sweet. Last time Zach did this, did he make a new channel, like text channel for this? There's a voice chat channel.
Am I audible?
Yes, you are.
Yay! And Discord is a liar because Discord says that I'm not audible.
All right, the voice chat channel is now there, fourth under.
Hello?
I believe everyone has speaking times, right? I don't have to unmute anyone.
What we don't have perms to is the voice chat channel. You do not have permission to send messages in this channel.
What? All right, hold on. All right, how about now?
How about now?
There we go. All right, hello, everyone.
Hello.
Hello. Silence.
Hello, I'm here. We're just talking. Nice.
Very awkward time.
Wow.
High quality fire track.
Alright, hold on. I'm gonna put on headphones.
Headphones? Okay. Hello?
Hello.
Alrighty, guys. Hello. Hi and welcome. Oh, Rob is self-muted. Can anyone hear Rob speak?
Maybe.
I can't.
Rob, say something.
Rob is currently fiddling with his settings to fix.
I can see that.
Hello.
Oh, hello. There you are.
Why are there two voice channels? There are?
There's two voice text channels. This is exciting.
All right, anyways, hello everyone. There were some things that I wanted to talk about, but I was wondering if you guys had anything that you wanted to talk about. Any questions you had about Replit?
What's next for Replit?
What's next for Replit? It's a good question.
Yeah, I've been trying to ask that a couple times.
Wait, so text channel Replit should we be using?
Use voice. Is there a different channel?
There's a voice chat one and there's a voice text one.
What is voice text? Oh, shoot. All right, yeah, you're right. All
I
right.
See voice text. Where is voice chat?
Voice chat.
Zach, is this your doing?
Probably.
Well, there goes voice chat, so.
By the way, my internet is guaranteed to go out sometime during this. My computer is stupid.
Alright. There we go. Now we're on the same page. Alright, so Angry Epic Banana asks, what's next for Replit? And that's kind of a hard question to answer, because we're all kind of working on different stuff.
Well, what are you working on then?
I'm trying to finish up folders, and I'm just doing like minor improvements around REPL top. Which is also something I want to talk about today, but we can get to that later.
Yeah.
Rob is experimenting with graphics, which is super neat.
When would that be coming to Explorers?
Rob?
That is a good question. I have no clue.
Will it be available for all languages?
That's the plan.
Or, like, what graphics library are you aiming at supporting? Like, SDL or something?
SDL works right now, so, but maybe some others as well.
Like, if you could get something like TK, GTK, or, like, what's it called?
QT should also work.
Yeah, QT.
I'm not sure.
TK would be nice, though. It's
fully working like X server.
It's, like, the only graphics library I actually know how to use well.
I'm trying to not have an X server. It's kind of heavyweight.
It also, like, It's also, like, directly built into TCL, so that would also be cool. But, like, if SDL's working, that'd be interesting to mess with. Is it fast?
I don't know yet.
Like, when you've been testing it, has it been fast?
Well, I don't have input working yet, so I don't know if it's fast.
Oh. You haven't? You tried, like, animating stuff?
I ran Quake.
That would be interesting to try to break once it's done. Once you can get it out to us.
I like how you think.
I guess I made it.
You made it. Welcome.
Okay.
Good job.
I did a good.
Did a good. Ferris and Sakan are working on some internal improvements to make our lives as developers here easier.
Oh, cool.
But probably won't.
That's what backend devs are supposed to do?
They do full stack, front and back.
I have no clue what that is, but I'm going to let them do it.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just.
Well, you can't stop them.
Well, we're basically moving from. We used to use JavaScript plus Flow, and we're moving to TypeScript.
Yuck, TypeScript.
I guess
it's an okay option. Didn't Replit use CoffeeScript at one time?
Oh wait, yeah, way back in the day.
I was looking through your entire repository on GitHub, and that was actually pretty interesting.
Yeah, that was all
TypeScript is dead. Or not,
yes, it is.
CoffeeScript is dead.
What? Yeah. Wait, what? No. Okay, CoffeeScript may be dead, but
TypeScript is very much alive.
Yeah,
TypeScript is weird. The one language I would consider using, other than like JavaScript or something for online stuff, is a language called Hax. If you've ever heard of that.
I have not.
It can run on like tons of different languages. Like, it can run on JavaScript, it can run on C++, it can run on ActionScript or whatever Flash uses. It can run on Python, and one of its backends called Neko, I've actually started getting into. It's like entire runtime is as small as Lua.
Cool.
But yeah, the language itself, it's mostly statically typed, and you can like interact with lots of different APIs, I guess, easily.
Yeah.
Just an option.
Yeah. So how long has this town hall been on before I joined?
We started at 2-ish. Took a little bit to get everyone set up.
It's not 2 o'clock, though.
Oh, to beginning of the hour, wherever you are.
It's like 5 o'clock.
So 10 minutes ago.
Yeah, 10 minutes ago.
Gotta update my packages.
Oh, what is Amasad doing?
He's doing
I doubt I said that correctly.
You can just call him Amgad.
Okay.
Wait, sorry, is my keyboard ear raping you?
Kind of.
It is.
But, what is Amasad doing?
Have we gotten our,
he's working on Founder stuff.
Have we gotten the, results from the code jam yet?
No. Okay. Speaking of that, Zach didn't think to actually read my help command fully, so he had, when he was trying to make folders, apparently he had no clue how to do it.
Alright, well, he had to look through many of them, so I'm sure, you know.
Oh yeah, and he didn't notice that, like, you can make different accounts and stuff and actually, does something. He assumed how it worked, and so I spammed his DMs.
Well, that's not him. Anyone.
I realized I forgot to encrypt the password in my make user command, so it didn't work.
Oh, I didn't encrypt anything like that. I just used, like, a hash
for that. I meant hashing, but same thing.
No, like, actual hash, as in the data type.
Oh yeah, I have a hash called users, and all the passwords are hashed.
Yeah, that's how I did it. I have no clue how actual hashing works.
I just used a library, bcrypt.
Oh.
Hey Rob,
I didn't use
anything. Asked about Selenium, and that requires Chrome WebDriver. Is there any reason that we can't get that on Replit Images?
That'll probably be under Polygot when that comes out.
Oh yeah, Polygot.
Heard that?
Yeah, Polygot's interesting.
That was your question.
I actually store the passwords in my folders for the OS. I stored the passwords in folders.
Well, I just have everything in global variables because you can't actually eval anything in my scripting language for the OS. Yeah.
I have everything in global variables, but I serialize it to JSON.
In between runs, when you enter the save or the exit command, it will save all the files, and in the user's home folder, it will say their encrypted password.
Oh,
nice.
I did not really finish my editor, but I actually got it, like, working in the terminal.
I just had my editor call whatever the default editor was on in the OS, which turned out to be Vim and a REPL.
Oh. Well, my file system was a virtual file system, so I couldn't use Vim or anything like that.
Mine was virtual too, but I made a temporary file and had it edit that.
Oh, I didn't do
really
anything.
Really bad editor.
Yeah, I spent tons of time trying to figure out why line numbering wasn't work instead of just trying to make it work in general, and that's what ate up a lot of my time.
Oh shoot, I should have added line numbering.
Well, I eventually just gave up because I was getting frustrated with ANSI commands. ANSI codes, but yeah, I got everything else working. I added this thing for my iPad since the arrow keys aren't registered, where I would do alt and then like WASD to move around, and it would send a control character, I guess. I don't know how it works, but it works.
Wait, what language did you use?
Ruby, obviously.
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 Well,
I mean, what other language is there?
Well, I mean, there's plenty of other languages, and I could use most of them, just not Python.
Yeah, I used Perl 6 for mine.
Well, I actually tried using Perl 6 and TCL for mine, but my execution complex came in and it was just too hard. So I ended up making it in Ruby so I could make tons of spaghetti code. And it worked.
Mine is pretty much spaghetti code. Let me give.
Well,
I use lots of given when statements.
Well, duh, because those are like it's a switch case statement, but with pattern matching.
Yeah.
But I used a lot of nested hashes and stuff like that.
I used a lot of that too.
I tried to avoid spaghetti code, but that's why mine is probably more simple.
Yeah,
well,
spaghetti
code delicious.
I'm used to saying EQV instead of equals for string comparison.
Well, the problem with my when I did in Perl 6 was that I didn't actually know how to organize anything because it was acting weird. And in TCL hates nested data structures.
Oh, it does?
Because it's, yeah, because everything's a string.
Oh, yeah, right.
Yeah, yeah. It could have worked, though, because TCL is like a Lisp, so it would have been really easy to make a shell.
TCL is T-Series confirmed.
No. TCL is a TV confirmed.
That, too.
Hey, quick question, guys. REPL talk, how, I'm just curious, how often do you guys check it or use it or post on it?
Oh, I don't usually post on it that much unless I'm, like, helping someone, but
I don't think I've ever made a post on it.
I try to check it at least once a day, like, in the channel, in the REPL talk channel.
Right, right.
But, usually just to, like, report spam posts and stuff.
I see.
Wait, are you talking about REPL talk on Discord or REPL talk on REPL?
Oh, REPL talk on Replit. Sorry.
I'm
like
talking about
REPL
that.
Talk. Yeah, I know. We were just clarifying for others.
Is Wack even in the town hall?
Yeah. No, he's working on stuff. I think he has, like, finals or something.
I'm gonna be right.
Thanks, ABC. Yeah, so we're trying to see what we can do to get more people to use REPL talk because we notice that there are posts,
right,
but
back.
not many comments. So
I mean,
see
maybe
if
you
we
could
can increase engagement. Yeah.
Maybe you could make like the help and reviews channel read only and just say go to REPL talk or something.
Yeah, that's an idea.
I'm back.
That's an idea.
Sorry, I got a call. But obviously this is more important.
So, oh yeah. Tim Chen, you keep saying that you want to get rid of the Ace editor and move completely to Monaco.
Alright, let's
yeah,
clarify
this
something.
This conversation.
Do you want to avoid a situation where we have to maintain two different editors? That's what we're trying to avoid.
Okay, well, how sense. I see it is Ace was already working before, so why not just keep that?
Where are
Does
you
it work
using
with
Monaco?
Huh?
Where are you using Monaco?
Monaco is the default for desktop. But
Ace
like
is on,
the
like iPads.
Yeah, and the version of Ace Replit uses hasn't been updated in like 3 years, and it's gotten a lot better since.
It's like I'm using a
so
really
Ferris
updated version
knows
of Ubuntu.
More about why we switched.
Okay, is he here? You should get him on here.
So apparently it's mostly for LSP, which we
LSP?
Couldn't get with Ace. Yeah, code IntelliSense.
Well, you do. I was looking at the like new versions of Ace, and it seems to have more autocomplete features.
Yeah, but it's more than just
for every language. Well, yeah. Well, for every language.
Command palette.
Yeah. Well, for every language now. It takes the keywords that are, like, in the language lexer, I guess, and automatically, like, lets you choose those for autocomplete.
Yeah, autocomplete's not really, like, all that you get with LSP, right? Like,
I guess, but some languages also have, like, built-in code snippets and stuff like that.
Yeah, that's also not what we... That's not, like,
introspection, I guess.
There's a bunch of stuff that you get with LSP that you don't get.
Is LSP like
listed.
Language server protocol or something?
Yes, that is exactly it.
Yay, I'm smart.
So smart.
Well,
I just know that mostly from VS Code and some languages that say language.
Yes, exactly. And that's why, because Monaco is basically VS.
Yeah.
But well, my problem with Monaco is that besides it not having a Solarize Dark theme and it removes all my tabs on empty lines, it is not compatible with mobile devices, and it says that on their website.
Yeah.
So,
that we are
is there
well
any
aware.
Way to find like some sort of medium?
Yeah.
Eventually, I think.
I wish we could have multiple tabs in REPL, like multiple tabs of files open, so you don't have to always be on the left bar.
But,
yeah,
but like,
too.
If there could be some sort of medium between, mobile friendly. Editor like Ace and desktop friendly editor like Monaco, that would be ideal, I think.
Yeah, I think they're gonna just make Monaco more mobile friendly.
Well, it doesn't work that way. It says on their website that it's not made for mobile devices, and if Microsoft made it, they probably know what they're talking about.
Well, welcome to open source. We'll just, you know, go in there and make it better for mobile devices.
Well, what if you had to update Oh, you're talking about like Monaco itself, not your version of it.
Yeah, make a pull request or something.
Yeah,
we could make
like
a pull request, or we could just fork it.
Well, then.
If you fork it, you could wind up being behind.
Yeah. Well, then you just, rebase your fork.
Yeah, there are GitHub bots that automate that.
I don't even know how that works.
Yeah, Matt, I'll write us a bot. Thanks, Matt.
Would you guys make it so you can add, like, more themes and stuff and change options?
Themes is kind of complex. Obviously, there are Solarize Dark themes for Monaco. We just don't support loading.
Is
there
any
way where you could, like, upload a CSS file and it uses that? Would be kind of cool.
Didn't someone make, like, this thing a while back? I forget who it was.
Yeah,
Matt made
like,
a...
an extension thing. But
yeah,
like,
that. You could
supported.
Maybe do something like that.
Yeah.
But also,
I have no style sense, so I couldn't do that.
But like, if you could make it so it doesn't, like, remove empty white space, that would be awesome. Or, like, just configure the little stuff like that.
Why do you want it to... Why don't you want it to remove empty white space?
Because it gets really annoying when I'm using the arrow keys to navigate. Or if I want to set a certain amount of lines for like part of my code, if that makes sense, and I go back to it later, I don't want to have to re-indent everything. It just becomes kind of a pain.
Yeah, that's annoying. I have that problem too.
See, I'm not the only one.
Which problem?
I don't know. Maybe I'm just used to that behavior because you obviously don't want like. You don't want trailing white space in your file, like when you save it.
Well, maybe there's a button to trim the white space or something.
Well, like, if I want to get rid of empty white space, I can, but, like, while I'm working on the project, I don't want to have to manage that as along with coding.
It would also be cool if there's, like, a prettify feature.
That
you can that
used
off.
To exist for a few languages,
there's
but
yeah,
it's
like
button.
It's at the top, yeah.
Hey, really?
Some languages like C++ and I think JavaScript, yeah.
Zach, if you're saying anything, we can't hear you.
Me?
Okay, I don't see it on JavaScript.
Oh, there we go.
Wait, you can't hear me? All
right, yeah. So we get the need for like. These like fine tuning of the configuration, right? Like everyone has their own ideal settings for the IDE, but figuring out some way to present that to the user in a way that's not overwhelming is a challenge that we're still trying to figure out. And this is not just for the editor, right? This is for the rest of the site as well.
Maybe there could just be like a poll, and what the top few answers would be.
Well, no, because we don't. It's not just about like. What most people want.
Yeah, that's true.
Like we're opinionated in some ways.
Yeah, that's true.
And
yeah, I would like Emmet support Bad Villain. That'd be cool.
Okay, yeah. For those types of things, pretty much anything related to languages will be languages or dependencies or any of that stuff will be coming with Polyglot.
Well,
okay.
But are you talking about like for the editor or for like in general?
I'm saying in general. We don't want to. We're trying to avoid
like. I was talking
like,
about bad feelings
loads.
Question, but yeah.
Oh,
I could. I could like make, stuff for, I could make highlighting for missing languages in Monaco. I already made TCL, and I'm working on like three other languages right now.
Yeah, sure. Your TCL one got merged, right?
Yeah, it did. I'm just
nice.
Waiting for it to be I'm just waiting for the next release.
Nice.
I'm curious, what is Polyglot? I don't really understand the whole thing.
Rob is the Polyglot king. Rob?
Polyglot is basically a reworking of how languages work so that you can do like multi-language
the term
thing.
By, Polyglot developer or Polyglot or whatever.
No.
I've heard that thrown around a few times. It's like
where
someone who knows
from?
A bunch of languages or something.
Wait, so like me?
Yeah, sure.
I'm the ultimate polyglot. They need to make a new word for me.
Yeah, so
I would call it the angry epic banana.
Achaka, the way that it works right now is that every language basically has its own image, right? That we have to load up. So if we want to add new languages, we have to find a new image, a new like Linux image with that, with those the language and the dependencies.
Yeah.
And it's
or
just not a very
do...
scalable solution.
Can't you make your own Docker image?
Well, right, but the point is that we'd have to have like a different one for every.
You
language,
can't use
right?
Docker images in Polyglot though. Just something that. Oh yeah, Rob. Why can't you? Why is there no way to have any sort of pseudo access?
Because I decided you don't get it.
Well,
that's
mean,
not a good
Google
reason.
Do rn-rf/star or something.
Well,
why don't you give me sudo access to your computer?
Oh, yeah. I'm on Windows.
I'm on Linux,
Oof.
So let me just delete sudo.
Oh, I
yeah.
did that
wow.
once. That was a mistake.
One time I accidentally deleted GCC.
Ah.
And then like APT stopped working and it was kind of a nightmare.
Well, there's this one time on my Raspberry Pi that I didn't know how anything on Linux worked, so I decided to change edit access in the var folder. I ended up having to reinstall the entire operating system.
Oh, wow. Yeah, I've had to reinstall my operating system a few times, because back when I was dual-booting Linux with Windows, whenever I booted to my Windows, for some reason my Linux broke. Probably because Windows didn't realize that it didn't have the entire computer as its partition.
Yeah, see, look at everything that
so
can go wrong if you have sudo.
It's
not safe.
Well, there should be some sort of alternative, because, like, what if... I think being able to use a
what?
Docker image would be much faster
okay,
than the
go.
Setup I have for stuff.
Bye.
Bye.
Even if you had sudo, you wouldn't be able to use Docker, so it's kind of a...
Wait, what? But I was looking on the website. I have no clue how Docker works, but it says that's all you need.
Well, it's more complicated than that.
That's just... I just have a Perl file that installs it if it's not installed and doesn't if it's already installed. But it's kind of slow.
So Docker uses cgroups, but like you're already inside a cgroup when you're in a container, so you can't really have like cgroups in the cgroup.
This is going back a bit, but about the configuration, have you considered making certain things configurable via environment variables?
That would be interesting.
That would be interesting. I think. So I'm
Wait,
not. I don't
do
use
that?
VS Code. We can, but we want to keep the experience as close to like we want it to work off of Replit as well, you know. So we have like a bunch of.
Well, it should work. It should be able to work how the user wants it on Replit, right?
I'm thinking, like, so you know how on Repellit it allows you to search up packages, and then when you select a package, it'll put it into the requirements.txt?
That's only for some languages.
Okay, yeah. But for that languages, what if there was also an option that you could search up different configuration values, select one, and it would put it into a .env file?
That might work.
Yeah, I think maybe an editor.config file or something like that is the best solution moving forward, but it's still very rough, and we don't have, like, it's not planned in the pipeline.
You could just have, like, a JSON file for it or something.
Alright.
Yeah.
Or, like, you could have an advanced settings menu in the normal settings menu.
Nah, that's,
I mean, that's how everything else in the universe works.
Maybe. We'll see.
Like in Chrome, there's settings and then advanced settings, so I don't think it would overwhelm the user that much.
Yeah, we'll see. We're kind of, we don't want to mess around with the UI too much, especially since if we reverse any changes, it's just going to confuse the user, or if we, like, make a lot of different changes, so.
Then it should be gradual.
Oh, right. Is Maka here?
Oh, no, it says he
Maka.
Is.
Well, Maka's here, but is he
lurking.
Here?
Lurking.
Lurking. Maka, do you want to introduce yourself now that you are here?
Sure, I'm Maka. I am trying to take over some of the support tasks from Tim so he can do more engineering work. You'll see me in Discord, you'll be able to talk to me in support if you email us, et cetera, et cetera. I don't know, if you guys have questions, let me know. Apparently we're voting on what I eat periodically, which is weird, but okay.
Should eat spaghetti next.
Spaghetti code.
I think we decided on Chinese, right?
No,
I think something Italian would be better.
Sorry, that's not one of the options. Not a
well,
lot.
I'm making it an option.
Who cares what you think?
Ooh.
Yeah, so that's not cool. Don't do that.
Yeah, diss Python instead.
So, Timjin, just out of curiosity, a while back there was a post on Repel Talk about they were trying to email, figure out what the email was because they thought they found a vulnerability. Did they?
who? Where?
It was a while back. I don't know, they're trying to get, like, the support email, or, like, figure out what email so they could
return
something.
Yeah, they came in, we talked to them.
Yeah, there's been a few, like, vulnerability things. Some of them are legit, some of them are not. I guess it's about what you expect.
About 85% of them are like, look, we got shell. We're like, yeah, okay, that's the point.
Yeah, like they say, oh, we're reporting a remote code execution vulnerability. And we're like, yeah, that's literally our service. Execute code remotely.
That's what I was thinking.
Yeah. But every once in a while we get like a real thing. So it's always good to keep in them.
Oh, Rob, I see the conversation you're having in the chat. That reminds me that install PKG is broken.
Yeah,
like,
I mean,
and Polyglot.
It's kind of a hack, so.
Well, obviously, I have to hack it to get a hack to work.
So the way that it works is it installs the packages in a place that they don't actually belong and then kind of tries to make that work. And sometimes that's just not gonna work.
Well,
that's what
like
RIMP does.
Well, like when I in my Scala REPL, what it does is that for some reason it creates like the fake environment, but then it installs everything in the share folder. So I have to move everything from the share folder to, like, bin or whatever.
I mean, it installs it wherever the package to install it, but it just puts it in home instead of root.
Oh, no. Like, if I have .apt, instead of installing the actual Scala executable and compiler in bin, it puts it in user share.
Nah, I don't know. Take that up with the Ubuntu package creators.
Well, aren't you... Wait, you didn't make this command?
I made the command, but the command just...
Okay, I'm talking about what you're doing.
Yeah, that's the way it's set up in the package. Like, if you install it on Ubuntu, that's where it goes.
Well, I've installed it on Ubuntu, and it didn't do that, so...
I mean, you can just, like, cat the install package command and see what it does. It's not like it, like, makes up any kind of crazy, like, path rewriting. It just extracts the APK file.
I didn't even think about... And also, when you install something that, like, kind of has a big runtime, like Free Pascal or something, it takes a really long time to load. Like, for the REPL itself to run.
Yeah, that's probably true. I mean, it has to synchronize all the files, so if it has a lot of files to synchronize.
Why does, I'm curious, so when REPL, what is different from when REPL installs packages? And then if I was going to, like, try and use pip in the terminal? Because when I use it in the terminal, it says it doesn't have access. I'm just wondering why that is.
That's a long and complicated question, but it's on my to-do list for this week to fix that.
I expected that kind of answer.
So one thing to keep in mind is that some of these, like, for example, Polyglot is it's not meant for, like, people aren't supposed to be using it. It's just that you guys kind of know about it, so you guys can make Polyglot REPLs. But
yeah, we use it anyways. Well,
right.
Really, I'm just
what it means is that we're not officially supporting it, right? It's out there because we're just experimenting with it.
It's kind of like...
So just keep that in mind.
Well, it's like the X-term thing. Back when that was still being worked on, even though that we weren't really supposed to use it, we did anyways. So this isn't really any different.
It's a little different in that Polyglot may just go away completely.
Why?
Because the whole point of having Polyglot is that every language uses that image, not that it has its own language.
Well, yeah. Well, no. Like, Polyglot seems to work just fine. I know it's, like, gonna be used for individual languages.
I guess what I'm trying to say is if you try to use Polyglot for things that we don't already support, and you don't have a good time, then it's, like, kind of expected.
Mm. Well, I've gotten some things to work. But,
right, which is good, but if it doesn't work, then, like, you know, that's just how it is right now. You know?
Actually, the real problem is that you guys are using Bionic, and many of the packages I want aren't available on Bionic.
Well, what version would you prefer we use?
I'd have to look at what the other names begin, but, like, I can't even... Julia apparently isn't available for Bionic. Or if it is, it doesn't actually install. But, like, I was looking at Parrot, and that's only available on these two other ones that have weird names. But, like, it just seems like there's more options on other OSs.
Hello, K Paka.
Does Pygame work with ROM mode? I don't believe so.
Oh, it does.
It does?
Wait, does it have to use ROM mode?
It, like, barely works. It's not a good experience.
Wait,
I have a demo of it.
Is it actually using Sixels to work, or?
Yeah.
Oh, that's actually pretty interesting.
It's pretty much unplayable, though.
Can you even load sprites?
I mean, you can load everything.
But well, then will it run?
Not well.
Even if you're like on the hacker plan?
It's not like a CPU problem, it's more of just a like Sixels problem.
Sixels seemed fairly fast.
Really?
Yeah, for like the way I did it, they seemed pretty fast.
I think my computer is just garbage.
Oh, trust me, my computer's bigger piece of garbage. My phone is better than my computer.
Computer's pretty fast, but for some reason all of the Sixels things were very slow.
Oh, for me, when I used Sixels on my computer, it made them like twice as wide as they needed to be.
Yeah, mine too. On mine, it was half the height.
Well, it worked just fine on like my iPad and stuff. It worked on mobile.
Funny.
Oh yeah, that thing. Link Rob just posted. I tried it before and it crashed. The Pi game demo? Yeah, it crashed when I tried it.
It doesn't seem
because it sends a lot of Sixels.
I'm gonna try it.
Hey, recipe for target run failed. I don't think that's that descriptive of
I just have a blank window with a cursor.
It takes a while.
Actually, it's taking longer to install the packages right now.
Yeah, I got the same thing as Tim Chen.
I guess it broke, but the moral of the story is you can build a version of Pygame that works, but I wouldn't recommend.
Can you just use SDL in general, though? Like, not just Pygame? Because that may be why it's slow.
You can use SDL in general, but it's still not very good. Like, that Quake demo that I threw around, that uses SDL, but
For me, it's saying that one of the libraries doesn't exist, even though it just installed it.
Yeah, maybe the version number changed and or something like that.
Well, let me see. Yeah, it did. It's the libslang one.
Yeah. Ooh, League of Legends.
What?
What's your question, ABC?
Where did League of Legends come from?
I heard the like League of Legends join match sound.
ABC, are you asking if you could like connect to the Repellent sandbox from your computer? From the terminal?
I tried to launch X server, but it doesn't work yet. It like not enough iOctane. Because Xserver tries to do a bunch of stuff with the virtual consoles and all that jazz. Eventually, I hope Xserver will run.
And how would you be able to view the Xserver? Like, view what's going on?
We'll have like a new tab or something for basically graphics. I'm not sure how I can the IDE yet.
I mean, is there actually a way to do that with JavaScript? Like, to connect to an X server and display the graphics?
Yeah. Oh, app on Replit to X server somewhere? That should work. Yeah, you should be able to do that. You'd have to, like, open up your X server to the internet, which seems a little risky, but,
opening up anything to the internet is risky.
hey, Leon. Total silence, indeed.
Hi. I'm so late.
So late. All right, we're actually ending soon, in like a few minutes. Does anyone have anything that, any like final questions or requests that are not related to mobile or Ace?
What'd you guys think about Code Jam?
I just don't want to lose my files when I just...
Yeah, so we know that the experience with files is maybe not what you would expect. Mason's working on that now, so hopefully we have some...
Yeah, that sounds good, yeah.
Yeah, a lot of things happen that just make you scratch your head, so...
Yeah, we're completely rewriting file handling.
One thing that would be cool is, like, you type in, and as soon as there's no syntax error, it'll immediately automatically run your REPL.
Oh, that sounds dangerous.
Oh, yeah, like, I guess if you're having, like, a production thingy-mabobber.
Like, I would just always put in syntax errors and then only remove it when I want it to run, if that were the case.
Yeah, that wouldn't be good. Scratch that.
No worries. So Zwack actually asked about the Code Jam. So for those who participated, what do you guys think of it? And other feedback?
What did you say? You cut off a bit.
Oh, about the Code Jam. Just feedback about the Code Jam. Did you guys like it? General feedback around there.
Did anyone here participate in the Code Jam this time around?
Yeah, a few people are typing in the chat. Yeah, Archaka, come on. Say what you're thinking, or if you want to type it. We had a Code Jam this weekend, awesome. It was on operating.
I don't know, it was really fun. The challenge was good. Like, whoever came up with it came up with a good challenge.
I believe that is Thwack.
What did I miss?
Talking to you, Zwack.
I just saw what people are making recently in Repel Talk.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah, so I thought you guys might like it as well.
Alright, looks like general feedback is positive, which is good.
Yeah, I know I gotta finish and get the winners. I'm sorry, guys. I'll be doing that soon.
It's no rush, like... You have other important things to take care of, so really no rush. And, oh, yes, and today we launched a new challenge on REPL Talk with our standard $100, $50, $25 gift cards. And the topic is AI, which is really broad, and it's intentionally so. You can pretty much do anything that's remotely related to AI, whether it has, like, actual machine learning, or neural networks, or if it's just like, you know, a tic-tac-toe playing bot. So anything
neural
goes.
Just a bunch of if statements, come on.
Yeah.
Well, you might not win with the tic-tac-toe playing bot. I don't know.
So you should definitely try to get entries in earlier, because historically, the earlier you are, the better a chance you have at winning. So.
I suggest for people using Python, I found the TextGen RNN library recently. It makes training on text like the easiest thing. It's just crazy easy to use. I'd highly recommend it.
Can you type the name of that into chat?
Yeah. Use it in my Pokemon name generator. It is just absurdly easy.
Sir Napkin, what's VC?
Voice chat.
Oh, like, so have like a permanent channel open where helpers get VC.
Oh yeah, that would be great.
Well, my internet just died, just like I predicted.
I mean, you're talking to us.
All right, well, we'll think about it. No promises.
What was it about?
Permanent voice chat for helpers and such.
That may make conversations easier.
It also just doesn't make it easier for other people who are having the same problem if they come across it, because they only have basically half the conversation. Because whoever else.
A lot of the helpers are some of the most active people on the server, and I don't want them to be like all in a voice chat when new people come in and they might think
they're like, that wouldn't be what it would be for though, right? Like if you had a voice chat to help people, it wouldn't just be so people could talk.
Well, you know, people always use stuff for its intended purpose 100% of the time.
Yeah, Replit is a prime example of that.
Polygot.
Gee, I wonder how that came up.
Oh, here's another thing. A lot of the time, there are like packages on NPM that require pure dependencies. Is there a way to manage those with REPL.it?
That will be fixed in Polygot. We're basically going to have every dependency ever.
Polyglot sure, is ever. Just like the magical fix to everything.
It will be the magical fix to everything, yes.
There is still no interface to install Ruby gems.
Magical solution to everything.
Give me a solution to this then.
Yeah, it can actually determine whether or not your program will halt as well. It's pretty cool.
Oh, also, I saw like some hidden languages in the code of Replit a while back. What are those for?
Languages that we have because REPLs exist in that language, but we don't really support anymore. So we don't want people making new ones. For example, React Native.
Oh, well, like not that, but like ones I've never actually heard of before. They don't seem to do anything. The link to one of them didn't even work.
Well, they're hidden for a reason.
Oh,
that's what
and
I think
that,
Polygot.
Yeah, that actually reminds me. A long time ago, you guys had this language called, like, Caffeine or something, back when you had a lot of JavaScript languages. Would it be possible to, have that somewhere again?
Just make a Node.js REPL and install it as a package.
Anything I try to install in a Node.js REPL never works. It may be because I have no clue how that stuff works, but I'm pretty sure it's not me.
I don't know. It always works for me. Maybe it's because I have a cooler name or something. I don't know.
I think my name is pretty cool.
Ooh.
It ends in Akka.
Uh-oh. Here we go.
I'm sorry. It works, doesn't, Rob.
Oh no, why do bots work here? Oh no.
Oh wait, bots have access to voice text.
Wait, what?
Shakespeare just said something.
Wait, it did?
Oh yeah, try my app right now. I'm gonna come in for my app.
Alright. There, no, I just got rid of bots.
Okay.
Bots are banned.
The robot uprising has been subverted.
Oh, yeah.
Bad villain, about adding full version Kotlin.
Don't.
Hey. No, shush. that would best go on language requests. Just, like, add your vote to the mix, because honestly, once we get Polygot out to all the languages, then we'll start looking at, like, you know, the highly voted languages to see what we should be getting out.
Well, it still says on Replit that Julia is in progress. Is that actually true?
Ignore anything that's in progress unless it's on the feedback.
It's the only thing that's in progress.
Unless it's on the feedback board.
Okay, because, like,
ignore those labels.
Was it, like, started before Polygot was a thing?
Probably not.
Oh, I was going to say, if that's why, then I understand why it's not out yet.
Also, I don't know if S-Coder is in here, but congratulations, S-Coder. You got the helper role.
We do not have a way to where students can get raffles for free. Sister Napkin's question. I don't know if we plan on offering one. We'll talk internally about this. It's been something that people have been asking for.
Oh, Tim, yeah. I need some help with setting the editor fonts and stuff for my app. Do you have like time to help me with that?
I have no idea how I would do that.
Who did?
Someone just say boom in the background.
Oh, yeah, just someone in the background talking. I can't help with that.
Boom. All right.
Okay, so like, who did like the editor part for Ripple Edit?
Ferris did, but.
Oh, Ferris did.
Yeah.
Ferris should.
Bug Ferris to tell him anything that's editor related.
Yeah, yeah.
Should I go bug Ferris about keeping Ace and removing Monica?
No.
He seems like the right person.
I think your point has been made many times, and
really?
It does not need it reiterating. Yes.
Ferris loves Monica more than anyone, so you're gonna.
Oh, I can tell. Then why didn't he use a Monaco instead of Ace originally?
Didn't exist yet. But if I could go back in time and give him the Monaco source code before it was created, I would.
I wouldn't, personally.
Oh, we know exactly why.
You also wouldn't have a time machine in this scenario.
I mean, neither would you.
And on this note, I think the town hall meeting is done.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, this is pretty exciting.
Wait,
there's a question, like actual question.
All right, an actual question.
When I forget what it's called, but like, when is that feature where you can like push to GitHub, like push your REPLs to GitHub from REPL?
Push.
Whatever it's called, I don't know any GitHub terminology, like. Yeah, whatever that is. Like, when you edit a REPL, it updates on GitHub.
Someone's working on a GitHub integration.
First of all, it should be a button instead of just automatically doing it.
Definitely. You don't want, like, 100... You do not want 1,000 commits in one day.
Even that, you don't want any sensitive stuff to accidentally make it in.
Pulling from GitHub is... well on its way. I think pushing to GitHub will be done separately, and will
at least the ability,
or being able to edit anything on GitHub.
The ability to clone a repository, and then into a repl would be very.
That would be awesome.
And similar to this, I'm currently working on like a command line program that will deploy apps to REPL.it.
What do you mean deploy to it? Just upload to it, that's all you do?
Like you type in this command and it uploads it and runs it.
Wait, what? So like a CLI version for the whole thing?
Yeah, so there's a lot of demand for GitHub integration in both directions, and that is very much planned and very much something we want to do. So just keep an eye out for it, because that's draft REPL's progression.
Tag.
It's almost out. I would say give me like a week.
Mass Frost.
All right. Anyways, that's it for this town hall.
Congratulations to Ease, who got the helper role.
Hey, congrats.
You can say it was easy.
Oh, he's not even here.
Nope.
He has been playing Minecraft for 3 days.
It's a good game to play for 3 days. Alright.
Jack is
playing Windows. Alright, please don't play Piano, by the way.